What's up, guys? Welcome back to our channel. Today we're reacting to something that's very different than we've actually ever reacted to on our channel, which is industrial.
Yeah. Lately I've been on like this industrial kick, and I don't know too much about any bands within like the subgenre of metal that is industrial metal. So I'm pretty excited to just go on this journey. I recently checked out Ghost Mane's, like, a song from one of his newer albums, and that is definitely like industrial metal. And then of course I'm a fan of like Cyclone 9 and Dawn of Ashes, and what I have heard from Nine Inch Nails, them too. So I'm really excited. Steven showed me the Aesthetic Perfection a couple days ago, and guess what? They dropped a new song.
And for you guys that don't know, I love industrial. I've been into industrial since the early 2000s, and it's just one of my favorite subgenres of metal in general. I listen to a lot of industrial melodic metal, a lot of just industrial just in general. One of my all-time favorite bands is Faderhead, and of course also Cell Dweller, which a lot of people I know know about. Aesthetic Perfection. I had to show Shelby them. They are one of my favorite bands as well, and I can't wait to hear their new song. So, before we jump into this reaction to Dead Zone, is what it's called, we are going to, we're sort of out of it, by the way. We're just tired and in pain, and that's just kind of where it is right now. So,
bear with us.
Yeah, it's a thing.
It comes with being content creators, okay? We kind of, you know, we are like zombies coming out of a dead zone.
Yeah. All right, guys. All right, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and that bell. That way you know when we upload new videos. Let's go ahead and jump into Aesthetic Perfection's Dead Zone.
Sounds cool.
I like that. That's I thought it was gonna be a bigger drop.
The instrumentals kind of give me like Stranger Things theme song vibes. Hey.
It's crazy when you think about how much Aesthetic Perfection has changed over the years, but you can tell just with his voice. I've been listening to him since like 2014, I think. So hearing the clean vocals a lot, it's very different, but I love it.
I keep thinking the drops are going to be a little bit heavier, but I like this. It's very chill.
Yeah. It is very Stranger Things.
Yeah.
It is very Stranger Things.
Very. It's like a really good song to just vibe to.
Yeah. We're just like kind of here swaying back and forth. It's just like, yeah, this is dope.
I was like ready to dance, but you know, this is cool too.
When shows open back up, this would be a great opener.
It would actually.
I like that.
The raspiness
that came into that. Yeah, I like that a lot.
Thank you.
so dope. I really love it. I love the feel of the song.
Change here.
Mm-hmm. The industrial equivalent of breakdowns.
Like basically.
Build up to breakdowns.
Yep. Yeah.
I like that.
Me too. I kind of like how long they like left us hanging before it like kicked back in.
Same. You know what I feel like? Like this can go really well like on a drive. Like when we're just driving and just cruising.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking too. Just like a long like road trip kind of cruising drive.
I'm envisioning an entire music video to this right now too.
Yep.
Love it. That was dope. I really enjoyed that.
It was not at all what I was expecting. The first song I heard from them was The Great Depression, and then I recently heard Gods and Gold. And those two songs are very different from each other. Mm-hmm. And then I just hear Dead Zone, which is even more different from Gods and Gold, which, I don't know, it's crazy to like see how diverse his skills and like voice and like just music is.
Yeah.
So I liked it. I mean, it was a little bit on the monotoned kind of side a little bit, but like there was still enough, like, I don't know. I really want to say sprinkles because sprinkles are really exciting. So there was like enough like sprinkles throughout the song that kept your interest.
Yeah, for a fact. Now check this out. So Dead Zone, from what he's saying on his page, Dead Zone is the fourth installment of 12. I'll read it from his words. Dead Zone is the fourth installment of my 12 songs in 12 month project. Inspired by the music of my youth, Dead Zone is a blend of the 90s alternative and modern synthwave. A gritty breakbeat, which is what we're hearing, I like that, provides the backbone of a winding apart of Poggio's swirling synths and soaring vocals. That's pretty dope. I like that a lot.
Me too.
I feel like I'm excited to hear more. So 12 songs in 12 months, which means we're going to be getting another one next month, which I am excited about. And then I need to listen to the ones from March, February, and and January.
So I guess, when did Gods and Gold come out? It's a newer song. I don't know how new that is, though.
That one might have actually been January.
I was going to say, that may have been January. I'm not sure. That's something we'll just have to kind of look at, like, not during this video. Yeah, because I know that was a newer song, and then, like, I know that The Great Depression, according to YouTube, came out 12 years ago.
It was a long time ago.
It was a very long time ago, so they've really come a long way with their sound.
Which, it's cool. You know what's really different about industrial music changing from regular music changing? Is the fact that you still have the basics of industrial there. So with all the synths and whatnot there, so you still know that it is industrial. For like a lot of times when metal bands change and they just go from metal to alternative, they change their entire sound, which I'm okay with because I like when bands do that because they grow and they find what sound they want to get to. But this one with industrial, the growth is absolutely there in the writing and the feeling of what you really want to put out, but the basics of the synths and everything is still there, and I absolutely love that.
Yeah.
But guys, what did you think? This is our first industrial reaction. We're going to do more of these for sure because I get to take Shelby down an industrial road and show her other groups that she's never heard of. Have you ever heard of God Module?
Maybe.
All right. We got some stuff that we can actually look at. And if you listen to industrial, if you have any bands that you think that we should check out, If I've checked it out, of course, we'll still do the reaction, but for Shelby mainly, for sure. Let us know in the comments below. We will love to get those reactions out there. And of course, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell so you don't miss when we upload new videos. And
check us out on our social media so you can hang out with us outside of this video.
Oh, yeah. All right, guys. Until our next reaction, we'll see you later.
See ya. It's caught in the crossfire.